I want to show you how the find works in PI Coresight. What we're doing right now is we're on the home page of the PI Coresight server. This is just a web page, and what I can see here are all of the different displays that I have access to. Some of these are global displays or public displays that someone else has made and shared. You can see that by the little globe icon here in the corner of each one of those thumbnails. And some of these are my own private displays that I've built and haven't shared with anybody yet. But to show you how find works, what I'd like to do is I'm going to start a new display. And I do that by clicking the new button. And what I have here is a brand new display. So this is the canvas. This is where you will drag information on so that you can visualize it and you can interact with it. But before you can do that, you actually have to do a find. You have to have some results. So over here on the left-hand side of the screen is our find window. And what we have is we have a dialog box up here where we can enter in a search string, and then these are where our results will display. So there's a couple of different ways that you can do find. The first way I'm going to show you is just by doing an actual text string search. So I'm going to look for some boilers. I'm interested in one of my boilers, and so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to type in a wild card at the beginning, but I don't need one at the end here. PI Coresight will automatically assume a wild card at the end of your text string. So I'm going to search for boiler, and the way I do that is I click the little magnifying glass. Now when I click search, what's happening is PI Coresight is actually going out and searching my entire PI system. It's searching through my PI tag database. It's also searching through my PI AF database, as well as any other PI Coresight displays that I may have created or have access to with this word boiler in it. So you can see that we have some results here, and the first thing that we have are some PI AF elements, or sometimes we call those assets. Now you'll notice that these are different colors, these results. When it's a blue color, that means that is an exact name match. So you can see this is called Boiler 235, Boiler 210, and those definitely have the word boiler in them. Now some of these results are yellow, and that generally indicates either a description match, or perhaps in the case of a PI AF element, that would be an attribute about that particular asset, or it could be a child of that asset that had to do with boiler. And in this case, you can see cracking process has two children elements that are called boiler. Now, as we scroll through our results, let's see what else we can find. Let's see. Okay, so here we have some PI tags. Now you're going to see these icons are yellow, which again, remember, that means that that's a description match, not an actual tag name match. But here's some blue results. These are name matched. And then, of course, we have a PI Coresight display. That is also an exact match. So that's one way that you can do a search. Now, the other way you can do a search, you can do a more targeted search by searching and navigating through the tree. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to remove my results by clicking the refresh button here. Okay, and so now you see my results are gone. It forgot my search. But what you'll notice here is the name of my AF server. So you can actually navigate through your PI AF server to do a targeted search. So for example, if you had 20 different boilers and you knew the boilers that you were interested in were in a specific area, you might drill down into that area first before you did your search. So let's do that. So we're going to click and we're going to browse through our AF elements here, and I'm going to look at Houston, and we're going to look at the cracking process, and all of a sudden now I can see I have a lot of information, including boilers but other things. What you'll notice too is at the top of my screen I have these little breadcrumbs. So if at any point, if I've gone too deep or I just want to go somewhere else, I can always click on one of these breadcrumbs and reset my context. So if I wanted to go back to Houston, maybe I wanted to look at the milling process, for example. I could always change, and then now I can look at the information that's defined about the milling process. And if I want to go deeper into one of these boilers, I certainly can. And now these are all the attributes defined for boiler 209. So those are some of the different ways that you can search your PI system with PI Coresight.